morning everyone. So today we are the students of JSDC Jagdalpur, and our group 1 is presenting an experiment of impact testing machine through which we can determine the toughness of the specimen. So myself Mukh Sharma and my team members are Suman Ramteke and Neeraj Mishra. The impact testing machine setup: this is a hanging lever, this is a supporting block, this is a brake lever mechanism, and this is our reading scale which is in joules. So today we will see that this is our isode experiment. This is a specimen of the isode. So here in the specimen you all can see the dimensions of the specimen are: it is length of 75 mm, the depth and width is a square bar of 10 mm. Okay, so here we are creating a groove of 2 mm notch, that is in a 45 degree angle. So here you can see the angle is of 45 degree and a 2 mm depth of notch is there. In isode test we are doing in impact testing two experiments. One is isode and one is charpie. The length of the charpie specimen is 55 mm and the length of isode specimen is 75 mm. So here we are creating the notch from the depth of 28 mm from left side. There we will create a notch of in a center means 55, so we will create it 27.5 mm from the height of from left side. So the placement of our means specimen is in a vertical direction, and here in the hammer we will use, here you can see, so here you can see the upside is ball pin hammer and the down one is forming hammer. So in isode test we are using forming hammer to hit the specimen, and the notch will, it will be placed in this vise. So here you can see that here vise is there. Here the notch will place the hammer position. So let's tight the notch. Okay, so we are here, the fittings are done, and now let's test the toughness of the specimen. Main motto of this impact testing experiment: if the material will totally break down, then we can say that the toughness of that specimen is low. But if it will bend or not break down, then the toughness is high, so we can use it in the fields where we have to use the high toughness material. So as you all can see here, this is a scale of our isode and charpie test. So inside here you can see the scale is there and outside a scale is there. The scale has one division and is equal to 2 joules for charpie. Okay, so and for isode it is also one division is equal to 2 joules. So inside one is our isode one and outside reading scale is our charpie one. So here you can see if the hammer is in rest position, here we are having so much error. So here you can see the highest value is 164 units. So here you can see 164 minus 140, approximately 148 it is having. So here if we will subtract from 164, 147 or 148, so it is coming 17 divisions. We will subtract 13 divisions from the final reading. So now in impact testing machine, here we are having two setups of hammer. As I told, here we are having a ball pin hammer and forming hammer. So for charpie test, we put our hammer setup from here. So we put our hammer setup in 140 degree angle. Here we will open the bolts and we will attach this whole hammer setup in 140 degree angle. Now for isode test, we are having a setup of our hammer, forming hammer, in a position of 90 degree angle. So the proceedings of this impact testing test will be taken away by Suman Ramteke.
Thank you,
Mom.
My name is Suman Ramteke. And I will continue this experiment. This is our hammer, as my friend told you. This is a forming hammer. And this is the handle. By revolving this handle, we release the forming hammer, so it will hit the specimen, and we all know about the properties of the specimen. Before releasing the hammer, we have to see that no one will stand front or back side of the hammer. So now I would like to call my friend Neeraj Mishra to tell you about the property of our specimen.
When we hit the specimen, the hammer is stopped, initially stopped. So I would like to call Moksh to raise the hammer. We will help to Palanki. We will remove the specimen from the machine wise. See that the specimen is bending, so it show that the specimen is highly tough. If the material is broken, the specimen will less tough.
So here you can see before and we have seen that in the machine we are having an error of 17 joules. So here our reading is coming on 142. So if we will subtract the 17 joule from 142, it will come near about 125 joules. So the energy absorbed by this material is 125 joules. So as you all can see, many doubts occur in this impact testing machine that why the reading maximum value is here, why zero is not here. So the simple reason is, if we are main motive is to test the toughness of the main specimen. So here the maximum value means more deflection, body will be less tough. Okay. So here if less deflection will be there, high the value of toughness will be there. If less deflection will be there, then the hammer will not move, means not move more. So here you can see, if the as in our object also means in our specimen also, you all have seen that our reading has moved slightly up, not more up. So means the high toughness is there. If the pendulum will move more in upward direction, then the body will be less tough. So this is the main reason that the zero value is not from the here, the maximum value from here. So let's I will do the experiment without the specimen, so the doubts will be clarified. Here you can see I am releasing the hammer, and here you can see the reading has not reached to zero. Means here as we know that the 17 division error is there. So this is the 17 division error. Also you can see in our ISO test this hammer position is of 90 degree. So here you all can see that here is 90 degree. Here it is coming 90 degrees. So here we are having 20 degree upwards. So here also we are having 20 degree upwards. Also in Charpy test you all can see here the placement of our hammer is of 140 degree. So the 140 degree upwards it is coming. So that's the main reason of the scale why the maximum value is in the downward direction. Sir, so now we will do the calculation part of our ISO test in an impact testing machine. So let's do the calculations of impact testing machine of specimen ISOD. So initially we got the reading R1 as 17 joules. This is an error which we got initially. Then the final reading which we got after the hammer hit the specimen, that is 142 joules. And the length of the hammer of the pendulum that we will be required in the finding the impact velocity and angle of rise. So that is our 0.8 meter. And the angle of rise in ISOD we are taking as 90 degree, and in Charpy we will take it 140 degree. So let's do the calculations. First of all, we have to find the area below the groove. So as you all know, in our specimen we have taken 2 mm of groove. So here we will subtract 2 mm. So we will get 8 mm into 10 mm is equal to 80 mm square. So then after we will find the energy absorbed. So energy absorbed is final reading which we have got, means R1 plus the value of R2. So after doing this, solving this by calculator, we got 159 joules. So this is our total energy absorbed by the specimen. Now for finding the impact strength is the ratio of energy absorbed upon the area below groove. So it will be as 159 divided by the area below the groove is 80. So this will come in, this is in joules and this is in mm square. So your unit will be joule per mm square, and after solving with the calculator we will get the value as, the value we got is 1.2
9875. So this is our value of impact strength in joule per mm square. Now we will find the impact velocity. The formula for impact velocity is this is the impact velocity of the hammer which is hitting the specimen. So it is V is equal to under root 2gr into 1 minus cos alpha. Here the value of r is, before I have told, the length of the hammer's pendulum. So it is the arm length of the hammer. So let's put the values. So the values are, here we got g value is 9.81. We have to notice that the g value is in meter per second square. So here also we have to put the value of r in meter. So here we are having 0.8 meters, so this is 80 centimeter by 100 is in meters. So after converting this, if we will put in calculator, we will get the values are, value as 3.96 meter per second. This is the impact velocity of the hammer. So after that, we will find at last the angle of rise. The angle of rise means the after hitting the specimen, the rise of the hammer is. So here we will get the value as, this will be beta, alpha we are knowing as 90 degree. So here putting the values, R1 is 17 into R, this we will take as 880 cos beta minus cos 90. Okay, so here U value we are knowing as U value we got 159 joules, so we will put 159 divided by 17 into 80. Here we will take it here cos 90. Okay, so here we will go cos beta. So let's put the values. Now 159 divided by 17 into 80 plus cos 90. Cos 90, so here we will get the value as this. So we will do its cos inverse. So cos inverse of the answer we got before, and it's coming beta value as 83.286 degrees. So now if we want the angle of rise, we have to subtract the beta value from the 90 degree, because the angle of rise is 90 degree. So here if we will do the angle of rise, is equals 90 minus beta, so the value is 90 minus 83.286 equals 90 minus answer, that is 6.714 degree. So as you all know, in our specimen which we have done the impact test, the angle of rise is very less, so here it is also coming very less. So these are the calculation part of our impact testing machine IZOTE test.
So this is an experiment of impact testing machine of IZOTE specimen which we have performed. So thank you for watching this video.
Thank you.